Assalamu alaikum to all the students and a very warm welcome to you all in our English literature class today. Up till now we were having language classes. Now this is the lecture number one of English literature and I'm your English teacher, Sidra. As you can see on the screens that this is the cover page of your book and copy. This is your novel book, okay, David Copperfield. And Charles Dickens is the writer name. Okay. The main title of the novel is David Copperfield, in which you are told about all the, you may say, personal experiences, history, adventures, and so many things about a boy whose name is David Copperfield. And the novel is written by Charles Dickens. And this is the cover page of your copy. You know this thing. Now, when you will open your copy again, as I told you in the language classes, you have to maintain a proper index. Okay, there is a serial number, date must be there when you will start writing your assignments. Okay, this is the index page of your classwork copies, which you will be having by today from the Asif bookstore and uniforms. Okay, from this shop you will be having all the copies and books by today. I don't know about the books, but you will be having the copies over there. Okay, and this is the 300 pages wider copy from other copies. Okay, language and literature both copies are 300 pages wide, and this is starting from the left hand side. This is the English side. Okay, then you will be having here heading of midterm examination 2020 to 2021. First heading will be midterm examination. Then your novel name must be there, David Copperfield. Then at the third line, you have to write the lesson name. Okay, in this novel we are having some lessons, and in each and every lessons you will be having three chapters. Okay, in this whole novel you will be having 12 lessons. Okay, 12 lessons, from which 6 lessons you will be having in this midterm examination. Okay, 6 lessons are there in the midterm examination, and each and every lesson is having 3 chapters, 3 different chapters, 3 different headings of the experiences of David Copperfield. Okay, first heading of midterm examination, second of David Copperfield, which is the novel name, and the third one is lesson name. Then what you are writing in this copy about this lesson, about this novel, you have to write down from the fourth line: words, meaning, word sentences, question answers, reference to the context, and summary. Sometimes you will be having summary, or sometime you will be having character sketches. Okay, now there again, syllabus will be pasted. Okay, you will be provided a syllabus paper. You have to write here the heading at the red border, syllabus 2020 till 2021. Then it will be pasted over here of all 6 lessons name. Then this will be the left side page, and it will be your title page. Okay, you have to mention the name of the novel David Copperfield first. Then in the title page you have to give lesson number 1. As I told you that you are having total 12 lessons, and in midterm examination you have to write you have to complete 6 lessons. Okay, the first lesson is an unhappy childhood. You have to make heading over there, main title page. Okay, then in subtitles you have to write whatever in written work you will be having according or about all this lesson. Word meaning, how many word meaning we have, 1 till 12 or 1 till 10, whatever. Then word sentences, 1 till 5 or 1 till 8 or 1 till 10, whatever. Then question answers, how many questions will be having over here. You have to write the numbers also. Okay, question answers 1 till 10. Then RTC, or only one RTC we will be having over here. Okay, then summary. If you have the summary in this lesson, you have to write down the summary over here in the subtitle. If you don't have summary, then you will be having character sketch. Okay, and at the end of the book, at the backside of the book, you will be having one activity of each lesson. Okay, each lesson's completion, you have to complete the activity also. Okay, so at the end of this book, you will be having an activity regarding each and every lesson, like an unhappy childhood is one lesson, number one lesson, and you will be having at the back side that there is a activity regarding this lesson. So we all are having six activities of midterm and six activities of final term. So we will be having 12 activities at the back side of this novel book. Okay, so you have to write all these in the subtitles. Then we are when you will see the book, okay, when you will open the book, you will be having this contents. 12 lessons are here, okay, and then you will be having questions and activities also at the back side. Now this is the page of your novel book, okay, 1 till 6. Okay, 1 till 6 we will be having in our midterm exams, and 7 till 12 will be having in the final term. Okay. Now, this is the midterm lessons. Number 1 is an unhappy childhood. We will going to start today. Then we will continue it in the next class also. Okay, it will not be covered in the same today's class, because we are having some introductory slides also about this novel. Okay, then we are having Away From Home, I Start Work, Betsy Trotwood, The Humble Mr. Heap, and Old Friend. I Start Work means this is the novel all about David Copperfield, and everything is the personal history, personal experiences, personal life of David Copperfield. Okay, so I means the boy, David Copperfield, is telling that my unhappy childhood and why I was away from home and where I was. Then I start work. In what circumstances I had to start the work. Then who is Betsy Trotwood to me? Means David Copperfield ki kaun hoti hai wo? Then what about her? Then the humble Mr. Heap and old friends. So this is the first page of before starting the writings of novel, you will be having this page that this is the David Copperfield. This is the boy, David Copperfield, and he is just entered in the Salem House, which is the boarding school. And these all are his friends. Okay, this is the, you may say, first day of him. That's why he is having some problems by his face. Okay. Now, about the writer. First, we are having some introductory points about the writer, who is Charles Dickens. He was a British author who penned beloved classic. Penned means he wrote. Okay, who had written down beloved classics means so many liked stories, liked novels, which are very much liked by the people, by the viewers, by the readers. Okay, such as Hard Times, A Christmas Carol, David Copperfield, and Great Expectations. These are four novels written names of him, which were liked a lot, which were beloved stories. Okay, now early life and education. Dickens was born on February 7, 1812 in Portsmouth on the southern coast of England, and he took his early education over there. Quick facts about him are his name, Charles Dickens, date of birth, February 7, 1812, date of death, okay, 9th June, 1870. It means he lived around 58 years, maybe. Yes, okay. Then place of birth, Portsmouth, England, United Kingdom, and the death place also United Kingdom, but the state or city could be changed. Okay, Chatham, Kent, United Kingdom. Now this is the David Copperfield picture. Okay, you can see over here. Then about David Copperfield, what we are some introductory points over here. David Copperfield is the 8th novel by Charles Dickens. The novel's full title is The Personal History, Adventures, Experience, and Observation of David Copperfield, the younger of Blunderstone Rookery. Blunderstone Rookery is the father of David Copperfield, okay? And he was the younger boy of him. David Copperfield actually is the 8th novel written by Charles Dickens, and its full title is the, you may say, he inspired by the personal history, personal life experiences, adventures, and observations of David Copperfield, who is the younger boy of Blunderstone Rookery. David Copperfield is the hero after which the 1850 Charles Dickens novel David Copperfield was named. It actually, this is the name of the hero okay, and by the name he got inspired and then he put his novel's name David Copperfield. The character is widely thought to be based on Dickens himself, means the character is having so many characteristics of his own lives. Whose lives? Charles Dickens' lives, means the writer has put so many elements of his own life, of himself in this character, incorporating many elements of his own life. Okay, so many students asked me that whether it is a true story or not. Okay, this is the answer. Now, it would seem that Dickens, like most writers, we always think that whenever this person is writing something or telling us something, it is all about his own life. Okay, it is not every time right. Okay, sometimes people grab different point of views of different people, his own point of view also, and then combine the things and then make a masterpiece, you may say. Okay, and then start writing any novel or any written work. So here is also, it is thought to be the his personal life, but it is not true. In the draft, drew from his own life experience in the drafting of David Copperfield, but to consider it a true story would be a huge stretch. Okay, means it is not totally true that David Copperfield is his own life experiences only. It is definitely a work of fiction, means it is a manghadat, you may say it is a fictitious story. Kuch cheezein he has fictionary, he has put in the novel, and some things are about his own himself. Okay, when the sensitive people, you may say, when the people who are having very sensitive mind or heart, they inspired by the natural things also, some weaknesses also, some weak points also, some strength of the people also, maybe it had happened with his own himself, and some things with his friends. So he combined all the experiences of different people, some of his own also, and then he made this story as a very wonderful masterpiece of him. It is definitely a work of fiction, means which is imaginary. Okay, kuch sochi samjhi cheeze hain iske andar, it is not about the true completely, with some elements inspired by the fact. Now, if we talk about the theme, one of the themes of David Copperfield is the way in which the poor suffer but conduct themselves with great honesty and nobility. Means in the whole lesson we are having, it is all about the person who is having a very poor and simple life. He suffers a lot to conduct himself with great honesty and nobility, but he never leaves his honesty and nobility, his truthfulness, his inner beauty, he never leaves about it. For example, other than David Copperfield, Ham lives in a house made up of a boat and has little money. Okay, Ham is a friend of David Copperfield. He used to live in a house which is made up of boat and has little money. Okay, very little amount of money he has got, but he is an honorable man who lives neatly and respectfully. Okay, so the theme of this whole novel is the people who are very simple, very poor, okay, but they never leave their honesty, their nobility, their respect, their self-respect, and their truthfulness. They never compromise on these all things, whether they are poor. Okay, now come to the lesson number one, which is an unhappy childhood. Okay, these are some important characters of the lesson. Obviously, main character is David Copperfield, Clara, Peggotty, Mr. Murdstone, Miss Murdstone, Ham, and Emily. David Copperfield's mother name is Clara. Who is Clara? Clara is the mother name. Clara is mother of David Copperfield. Okay. Peggotty is their maid servant. Okay. Peggotty is the maid servant of Clara and David Copperfield both. Okay. She brought up David. Mr. Murdstone is actually the friend of Clara, you may say, but after some time, in the first lesson you will see that Clara got married with Mr. Murdstone. So he becomes the stepfather of David Copperfield. Then there is a Miss Murdstone. Miss Murdstone is the sister of Mr. Murdstone. They both are sister and brother. Then there is Ham. Ham is nephew of Peggotty. Okay, she is the maid servant of Clara and David Copperfield, and Ham is her nephew. Emily is also lived with Peggotty at Yarmouth. You will get to know about her in the lesson. Muhammad Arif, if you are not getting my voice, please check your own system. Okay, now, actually, the novel David Copperfield is all about a child who had to struggle a lot for his survival. Okay, for his whole life, he had to struggle a lot and tolerate so many things. And he had to bear so many things, so many problems, which we cannot even imagine, because we are having a very simple and luxurious life here. We didn't have to make a lot of you may say that we don't have to struggle a lot for our survival, but he had to do everything by his own. Okay, because when he was born, his own father had died, Blunderstone. Okay, he had died. So his stepfather didn't like him, and he did not try to tolerate him at the house. Okay. Now we are having this introduction about this novel, that among the 15 novels Charles Dickens wrote, David Copperfield was his favorite and was based on his own life. Means partly it was based on his own life, Charles Dickens' life. Okay, we are now talking about Charles Dickens, the writer of the novel. The story is set in the 1800s, means in the 18th century in England, where Dickens lived. The story is written in the first person, and older David Copperfield tells what he remembers of his life. Means at the starting point, he is telling us about his own life experiences from the early stage, whatever he is remembered. From the time as a young boy under the care of his mother until he has his own family, he is telling us about his own life from the very young age till his own life when he has got his own family at the mature age. Okay, from the starting till the maturity of the age, he is telling everything, whatever he remembers. David meets a lot of people as he grows up. Gradually, he meets different people while studying and at work also. Some people are very cruel to him. Okay, when we talk about the people has to suffer a lot, means he had met so many cruel people over there in his life. But fortunately, he also meets some very nice people also who make his life happier than before. Apart from telling us about himself, David tells us how his friend have changed. Okay, a part of his own life experience about him, his own self, he has also talked about his relatives and his friends also. Okay, how their lives changed. Now we are having some important characters in this novel. The main characters of this novel, David Copperfield, who was born into an unfortunate family. He has been looked after by Peggotty, means his mother was not so much interested in his brought up. The servant of his family, Peggotty, brought him up. Mr. Murdstone, his stepfather, and Betsy Trotwood, his aunt, will also be in this novel, and they have played a very important role in his life. Okay, one of David's childhood friends is Emily, a girl who stays with Peggotty's family near the sea. Tommy Traddles and James Steerforth are his friends from his first school, which is Salem House. Salem House is actually a boarding school where he had to live for the whole life. Okay, stepfather sent him over there to get rid of him. Later, Betsy Trotwood's friend, Mr. Wickfield, introduces David to another school. He makes his friends Uriah Heep A young man who works for Mr. Wickfield. When he has finished school, David starts working for Mr. Spenlow. There he meets Dora, Mr. Spenlow's beautiful daughter. Means when he makes so many friends over there when he started again his studies about the subject law. Okay, he was studying law. Julia, he was his one of the friend. A young man who works for Mr. Wickfield. Okay, Mr. Wickfield was his boss as well, you may say, and Mr. Wickfield was the lawyer of Auntie Betsy. Okay, Auntie Betsy, Betsy Trotwood is his aunt, and Mr. Wickfield is the family lawyer of Auntie Betsy, and Uriah Heep is working under the supervision of Mr. Wickfield. He also, while studying, David Copperfield also worked, okay? He start practicing for law under the supervision of Mr. Spenlow. He has got a daughter whose name is Dora, and after some time Dora and David Copperfield got married also. Now we are having this some points about Charles Dickens. Charles Dickens was a very popular writer who lived in England in the 19th century. He was born in 1812 in Landport and spent his childhood in Kent. He had 7 brothers and sisters, and he was the second child in the family. His father had many debts and was put in prison when Charles was about 12. Okay, Charles Dickens was about 12 years old, his father was put into prison because of his debt liabilities. Charles Dickens had to earn money for his family by working at his relative's factory, labeling bottles for 6 shillings a week. See, these all are the his own life experiences which he put in this novel. Okay, you will get to know after some time. He attended a day school at the same time. 2 years later, he left school and worked at a lawyer's office. He taught himself shorthand when he was 16 because he wanted to be a reporter. At 19, he became one of the quickest and most accurate reporters in London. Later, he worked as an editor and a writer. Dickens never stopped writing after he published his first novel, The Pickwick Papers, in 1836 till 1837. Usually, he published a chapter of a novel every month. Okay, a chapter of a novel every month. He wrote 15 novels in total. The most popular ones include Oliver Twist, A Christmas Carol, David Copperfield, A Tale of Two Cities, and Great Expectations. His own favorite novel was David Copperfield, in which his own life is reflected. See, so many things are related to his own life experiences. Dickens spent most of his life in London. He died of a stroke in 1870 and was buried in Westminster Abbey. Okay. Now, this is the first lesson you are having on the screen. So I told you that every lesson has got chapters also. Okay. Every lesson is having 3 chapters in it. So I'm going to read this lesson. You may see on the screen if you don't have book. Early memories. In this chapter, he is telling about his early memories. Okay, whatever he is remember. The first people I can remember in my life are my mother and our servant Peggotty. I did not know my father at all. He had died before I was born. Means before his birth, Blunderstone had died. So he could only remember 2 people in his life. One, his mother Clara, and the other one is his servant Peggotty. My mother had pretty hair and a lovely shape, but Peggotty had no shape at all. Okay, her arms were very, now he is talking about, first he compared Clara and Peggotty, then he came to the Peggotty, then what he is telling us about the Peggotty's you may say outer look. Her arms were very hard and her cheeks were as red as apple. I was surprised the birds did not come and try to eat her. Means Peggotty's cheeks are so red that he wonders that why not birds come to eat her cheeks. I can still remember our house with the bedroom windows open. Now he is telling us the imaginary look of his own room. With the bedroom windows open to let the fresh air in, there was a garden with a high fence around it. I remember seeing butterflies and fruit trees. The fruit on these trees was riper and sweeter than any I have known since. Means in his own garden, there were very sweet fruits over there, and he had never eaten fruits like that in any other garden. Sometimes on cold evenings, we played games in front of the fire in the sitting room. I remember my mother, I remember means David's mother. David's remember that his mother, out of breath means saans ka phoolna. Okay, whenever we come after running, we come after and try to sit after doing so many works. Okay, so we become out of breath. Resting in a chair and twisting the ends of her hair round the fingers, means on his fingertips, she used to around her hair over there. I knew how proud she was of being so pretty, means she knows that she is pretty, so she was very proud on it. Peggotty and I were sitting one night by the fire alone. I was reading to Peggotty when the bell rang. The bell rang. He went to the door. My mother was there. Okay, when David over there, go there, went over there at the door. So what he saw after opening the door, that there was Clara, his mother, over there, and she's looking very pretty, looking especially very pretty. Okay, with her there was a gentleman also. Okay, my mother bent down to take me in her arms and kiss me. The gentleman put his hand on my head. Somehow I didn't like him. Okay, when Mr. Murdstone over there, the gentleman was Mr. Murdstone, and when Clara bent down to take him in her arms and kissed him, Mr. Murdstone, the gentleman, was also put his hand on the head of David Copperfield, but David Copperfield didn't like his touch on his head. When he touched my hand, he also touched my mother's hand, which was holding me. I was jealous because why David was jealous? Because from the starting, after his birth, he never shared his mother with anyone. Okay, because his father was not here, he hasn't got any child, any other sibling over there. So his mother is totally his own property, you may say. Okay, so he hadn't shared his mother, and he was very attached to his mother and Peggotty also, and he never shared his mother to anybody. So when Mr. Murdstone touched David's hand, he also touched his mother's hand, so which makes him jealous, which makes David jealous. My mother thanked the gentleman for bringing her home. Then Peggotty shut the door and we all went into the sitting room. Okay, they all went in the sitting room. Gradually, I got used to seeing this gentleman, but I never liked him. David Copperfield never liked him, never liked Mr. Murdstone, but he became used to of seeing him at the house. His name was Mr. Murdstone. Okay, his stepfather's name was Mr. Murdstone. One evening, about 2 months afterwards, Peggotty and I were together in the sitting room. My mother was out again. Clara was not at home, and Peggotty and David was sitting in the sitting room, and they were having some gossips or some discussion. Then Peggotty said suddenly that, Master Davy, would you like to go with me to Yarmouth? Actually, Yarmouth is the place where Peggotty and his brother, Mr. Peggotty. Miss Peggotty is the maid servant of David. Mr. Peggotty is her brother, okay, who lives at Yarmouth. So Miss Peggotty asked Master Davy that, would you like to go with me to Yarmouth? Okay, so I am going to stay for 2 weeks with my brother. Miss Peggotty's brother was living at Yarmouth, and she is going over there for 15 days for 2 weeks. So she is also asking to David that, would you like to go with me? There is the sea and the boats and the ships and the fishermen and the beach and my nephew Ham to play with you. She is now telling David that how many interesting things are over there. Okay, there were sea, fishermen will be over there, ships and boats will be over there, and a beach over there, and my nephew Ham is also there, who is over there to play with you. I means David replied that it would be great fun. Obviously, he will enjoy over there. So he was very happy to say yes to her. The day for our journey to Yarmouth soon arrived. We traveled in a farmer's cart, leaving in the morning after breakfast, means after that day when they will be leaving. They were about to leave in the farmer's cart. Just as we were going, my mother ran out to the gate. She called out to us to stop so she could kiss me. Okay, she bent and she hugged him and she kissed him. I cried and my mother cried too, because they are going far away for 2 weeks to each other. Okay, they are now separating for 2 weeks, so they both were crying. We left her standing by the garden gate. Then I saw Mr. Murdstone coming along the road to our house. When they were leaving, Mr. Murdstone was coming to the home. When he peeped out of the farmer's cart, when he looked out of the farmer's cart, he saw that Mr. Murdstone is getting angry on his mother. "Why you are crying?" Okay. He spoke to my mother and seemed to be angry with her for crying. I was looking back round the side of the cart. I wondered why he interfered, and Peggotty seemed to wonder also. Peggotty and David Copperfield, they both become surprised that why Mr. Murdstone is getting so much why he is getting so much interest in their personal life. If my mother is crying to leave me for 2 days, what is the problem with him? Okay, so he became very, very surprised that why he is getting so much interest and why he's interfering in our matters, because he had never shared his mother to anybody. Okay, so this is the end of the first chapter. Okay, if you have any problem, any word meaning, you may say. Okay, if you are having any difficulty in reading anything, you may ask. Okay, this is all about today's lecture. We will continue from the next chapter day after tomorrow in our next class. If you are having any problem, you may ask right now. Till that, I will see how many students are here so that I can mark the attendance. Okay, just give me 2 minutes. You may write your query, your questions in the chat box. Okay, I'll reply. Just go through the whatever you have noted down in your notebooks. If you have any problem, just give me 1 minute. Okay. Meaning of Yarmouth, Muhammad Arib. Yarmouth is a place name. Okay. Where Miss Peggotty and David went for 2 weeks to spend the holidays. This is the place name. Okay. And Talha, why you are giving your roll number here? Anybody else having any problem, they can ask. Okay, this video will be uploaded to the Google Classroom. Okay, if you are having any problem, you may ask over there. You may listen or you may watch this video on YouTube channel. Bete Anamta Rehan, nobody has got the class for copies right now, but today onwards, you will be having it from the stores. Okay, I know nobody has got the copies and books, but maybe you have received some information about it, that you have to buy the copies from Asif Book Store and Uniforms today onwards. By today, you will be having the copies. and the assignments will also be uploaded on the Google Classroom. Then you have to start writing the assignments. Okay, up till now there is nothing on the classroom for written. I was just giving you oral homework, but after today you will be having some assignments. Okay Talha, it's good that you have got the classwork copies. Today onwards you will be having it from the bookshop. Okay, so this is the end of our session. Okay, if you got anything you want to ask, you may ask in the Google Classroom. Okay, if there is any problem, then we will join this literature class again, inshallah, day after tomorrow, and we will continue this first lesson that day. Okay, thank you so much, everybody. Allah Hafiz.